Today's video is brought to you by Card Kingdom. We play Kitchen Fangs and win the game. Resolves. Well, we will sack it. Mill you. Sack it. Sack it. Infinite life. Infinite mill. Hello, everyone. It's Seth, probably better known as Saffron Olive, and it's time for another edition of Much Abrew About Nothing. And this week, we got a sweet one. We are playing Persist Combo. You might remember this. We did a deck tech of it last week. So the reason I'm hyped for this deck, well, one of the reasons, there's a couple of reasons. One is, it's a sweet deck. It's got the Limnity. It's got the Unlife Lock. It's got Shenanigans. But the biggest reason is, this is kind of like an upgraded version of a budget Magic deck we did a year ago, and it's always sweet to see a deck that kind of started off as budget Magic becoming a real deck of the format. So this is Persist Combo. Not going to do a big deck tech because we just had the instant deck tech, but quick 2-minute deck tech, jump right into the games, see if the new and improved and updated version of this budget Magic deck can actually compete in the modern format. So Persist Combo, it's built around Solemnity. This is one of our key cards. So we essentially have a bunch of different, somewhat connected combos in this deck. So combo number one, Solemnity, Phyrexian Unlife. We can't got die to damage as long as we have both of our enchantments on the battlefield. Solemnity is our main combo piece though. Unlife is just kind of a free roll because we're already playing Solemnity. So this is our backup combo, but it does sometimes just win us games. Our main combo, we have Solemnity and Anafenza, which are combo piece number one. So even though these cards might not look the same, actually one adds a counter, the other prevents counters, so they're kind of the opposite of each other. They fulfill the same role in our deck, which is making persist creatures infinite. We have Kitchen Figs, Safehold Elite, Putrid Goblin, all creatures with the persist mechanic. So when they die, they come back into play with a -1/-1 counter. If we have either Solemnity to just prevent that counter, or Anafenza to bolster a +1/+1 counter onto the persist creature to get rid of the -1/-1 counter, we essentially have infinite persist creatures. They die, they come back, they die, they come back. That means if we can throw a sacrifice outlet into the mix, like Altar of Dementia or Blasting Station, we just win the game. Altar of Dementia sacks to mill equal to the creature's power, so we just sacrifice our Safehold Elite, mill our opponent for two, it comes back into play, does not have a counter thanks to Solemnity or Anafenza, do it again, do it again. Blasting Station keeps sacking for a damage, so we just ping our opponent out of the game. We also have Carrion Feeder, just kind of a weird backup sack outlet. Doesn't actually win us the game, but if we do have Kitchen Fakes, it can still gain us infinite life, and it can be a backup win con if we are comboing off with Anafenza. Doesn't work with Solemnity because of the counter prevention, but if we're comboing with Anafenza, we can grow our Carrion Feeder infinitely big because it gets a +1/+1 counter whenever we sack something to it, and then just smash our opponent with like a million power Carrion Feeder, which is pretty sweet. Otherwise, we get some interaction, Thoughtseize, Inquisition to pick apart our opponent's hand, Path to Exile for removal, a bunch of dual lands. Probably the most important is Silent Clearing because we can cash it in for new cards. Sideboard Greater Oromancy to protect our Solemnity and Unlife. Disenchant to deal with graveyard hate. Some removal. Silence for control. Leyline of the Void for opposing graveyard decks. And that is Persist Combo for Modern. That's our budget brew deck for this week. Let's jump into a league, see if the deck can actually work in practice. How good is it? Is it better than the budget deck? Let's find out. Thanks for watching. I hope you all enjoy it, and I'll be back in a bit with the wrap-up. Today's video is brought to you by Card Kingdom, and right now you can get this sweet scoop soldier sticker when you order over at cardkingdom.com. Just mention in your order notes that you want a scoop soldier sticker when you go to check out. All right, much brew about nothing time. We are playing the new and improved, updated, maybe persist combo. We are gonna mulligan that. One land, no keep. All right. Well, this will keep. We can put Blasting Station to the bottom. We do need a lot of combo pieces still to make this work. Well, let's Godless Shrine, untapped, and Carrion Feeder go. So we have the Altar of Dementia. We still need Solemnity and Persist Creature. All right, opponent's playing Eldrazi Tron. Second Unlife is not super helpful. Well, Altar of Dementia, hit you for one. Our first hand would have been sweet if it actually had lands to cast things. Urza's mine. Opponent runs out the Mattery Shaper, sure. Oh no. All right, so we keep drawing redundant pieces of the same combo piece instead of additional combo pieces. Well, we will pass the turn. So we still need two pieces to be able to win the game. which is not exactly where we want to be. We've drawn 3 sack outlets, 2 Phyrexian Unlifes, 0 persist creatures or ways to make them infinite. All right, opponent has a Thought Not Seer. This blast zone is also a bit of an issue. That can get our opponent out from, if we do draw like Solemnity, out from under that part of the lock. Well, thankfully, we don't really care about this Thought Not because we have 2 essentially dead cards in hand. Takes another Altar of Dementia. Opponent combat hits us down to 14, sure. Well, Concealed Courtyard, go. Ugh. Yeah, this is not exactly how we drew it up. Opponent, waste. And Reality Smasher? Yeah, we're just super dead. All right, well this, So we got a top deck Solemnity, I think, to buy us time. Like, Solemnity into Anafenza, okay. Like, I guess the upside of Anafenza is we could just draw a Persist creature if our opponent doesn't have interaction. Burn down to 18. Technically, we have 2 turns. This one will hit us to negative life. The next one will infect us. Although, I guess we can chump block. But if we chump block, we're even further away from winning. Well, we'll see. We have gotten to the point where a single Persist creature could win us the game, assuming Anafenza sticks. All right, cracks the map. I assume our opponent just gets a Tron land. All right, gets a power plant and hits us. Sure. All right, well, come on. Persist creature, no interaction. Path. Well, we can path Thought Not Seer, draw a card. See if we can draw this persist creature. We draw Kitchen Finks. Okay, well, let's see if our opponent's got it. Kitchen Finks, do you have interaction? Do you have interaction? All right, so Anafenza triggers, Kitchen Finks triggers. Well, I mean, we gotta go for it. Comes back. Do they not have an answer? Do they not have an answer? Are we gonna win this? Are we gonna steal this? Oh my goodness. Oh! Well, that shows the power of the deck. We are often a single draw away from winning. Opponent's not scooping, which is interesting. Why are they not scooping? All right, and opponent! Whoa, 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 whoa. That was as clunky as a hand can possibly get. However, we got there. We got there at the end. Whew. Well, I mean, that is the reason to play the deck, is you can just get these random wins out of nowhere. And that was one of those cases where the random win out of nowhere. Oh, yeah. I mean, that's why you play all the combo pieces. All right, we will go up 2 Fatal Pushes. We will go down 2 Inquisitions. That was not a very good hand either. Collective Brutality, no. Leyline, no. Disenchant, probably not. Silence, I don't think so. Yeah, it is what it is. Running back like that. Well, that went really poorly and then really well. Do we need to bring in... They could have Pithing Needle. That would be annoying. Maybe we should have brought in Disenchant in case our opponent's pithing us. Ooh, all right. I like this hand. Thoughtseize into Altar into Solemnity into Kitchen Finks, win the game. That is, I mean, we do need to draw a white source. We need another land and we need it to be white, but this is almost exactly what we want. And our opponent's mulliganing aggressively, either looking for hate or trying to set up Tron. Urza's mine, opponent passing. And there's a land. All right, so play the Swamp. Thought sees you. Take Chalice. Opponent's got all lands. Can we get our combo pieces down before our opponent finds a Thought Not Seer? That's the question. Windswept Teeth, crack it. Grab a Plains. Altar of Dementia. Combo piece 1. We need 2 more turns. We need 2 more turns, phone it. Eldrazi Temple. Passing. Well, Windswept Teeth. Crack Windswept Teeth. Grab a Plains. Solemnity. Pass the turn. And next turn, we just got the combo. Opponent untaps. Do they find an answer? Ghost Quarter. Doesn't actually matter. Opponent passes. We untap. We play Kitchen Finks and win the game. That's it? Simple and easy? Resolves. Well, we will sack it. Mill you. They could have Graveyard Hate, I guess. Sack it. Sack it. Infinite life. Infinite mill. And, I mean, that's the deck. That's what we're trying to do. An opponent realizes what is happening, scoops it up, and that was beautiful. That was... why you play Persist Combo. Whew. Well, it's always sweet to see a budget Magic deck all grown up and actually sticking it to Tron. Sweet. All right, much brew about nothing time. We are playing, the new and improved and upgraded Persist combo, and I like this hand. So this hand, we have our backup Solemnity Lock, which can just beat some decks by itself. We have the Kitchen Finks. So all we technically need, so we have the lock already, and all we need to go infinite is a sac outlet for at least infinite life and potentially infinite other things as well. And we'll see what our opponent's up to. All right, so Windswept Beef, you. Opponent. Scalding Tarn, So this could mean counterspells. Counterspells would be good against what we're doing. Windswept Teeth, crack it, get a Godless Shrine, tapped. Untap, more Anoffenses. Well, Windswept Teeth, crack it, grab a Plains, and we will just Anoffensa. Goo. We'll see, it could be like Grixis Death Shadow, could be a control deck, could be like a Storm combo deck. There's a bunch of different decks that Scalding Tarn could represent. We'll see once they actually crack it. Opponent cracks for a Katira Triumph. All right. Huh. Was not expecting that. Stomping Grounds for our opponent. Untapped. So this could be like, I don't know what our opponent's doing. I'll go to combat, attack our opponent, play Silent Clearing, and yeah, let's just Kitchen Finks. We got the Anoffenza to protect it. All right, so our opponent is some sort of counterspell control deck by the looks. Opponent remands, untaps. Drawing some of our discard would be nice. That is our main plan against counterspell control decks in the main deck. Island, Uro. Okay. Well, who knows what our opponent's doing. Earl also could mean anything. Every deck plays it. Field of the Dead. All right. Well, we draw Thought Seize. Ugh. Well, play Kitchen Finks. Bulls drawn Anoffenza. Gain some life. Hit our opponent down to 15. So it's probably a Primeval Titan deck, actually. Like, Teemer Field of the Dead? Another land would be nice. Being able to Thought Seize and play Solemnity Arm Life would be a good next turn. About it. Passing. Interesting. Alright. Well, we go to combat. Oh, we will attack you. Alright, opponent bolts and Anoffenza. Hits us to... we hit our opponent to 12. We will Thought Seize our opponent. Oh, my goodness. We'll take the Lightning Bolt. That is a lot of factor fictions. Replay Anoffenza. Okay, so opponent's going to start drawing cards like crazy, and the Uro's coming back. They do have a Cryptic, but they don't technically have the blue mana. They need another blue source. This might just be a main phase Factor Fiction type turn. Okay, opponent draws a Mountain. And yeah, Factor Fiction number one. Well, I think we go lands versus spells, because we know our opponent needs lands, especially blue lands. The good news is, if we draw a Sac Outlet here, we just win. So we do have draws that just win us the game. All right, opponent takes the spells, mills the lands. Passes. Sac Outlet for the win? Come on. Come on, deck. That is it. We will play Altar of Dementia. We know our opponent's hand. It does not have answers to this. We will mill our opponent. And that is the game. Opponent scoops it up. Whoo! All right. Well, opponents got the counters. They got the counters for days. But we got the combo. All right. So opponent's playing control. Control to the max. What do we want against this deck? I think we want the silences. I could see an argument for the Leyline of the Voids. I wonder if it's worth it. It shuts down Uro pretty well. We saw Snapcasters. It might be worth it. The question is, what do we cut? I guess Inquisition's a little meh. It's not bad. It can still get like remands and Snapcasters, but it does dodge a lot of our opponents. A lot of our opponent's stuff does dodge it. We can go down an unlife. Maybe trim a Putrid Goblin and a Carrion Feeder. All right, let's bring in the Ley Lines. Let's try it. I mean, if you're buying against something like Dredge, you definitely want them. I think we still want them against this Uro deck, but all right, well, we'll keep this hand's fine. It's not thrilling, but we get a Thought Seize. We have two combo pieces once we get the lands for them. Which does mean we're technically, like, a combo piece away from trying to go infinite. Two Blasting Stations not especially helpful, but, yeah. You can't be picky. When you've got to play a critical mass of counterspells, of combo pieces, rather, to beat counterspells, you're going to have some draws that are like this. All right, opponent, island, and ops. Sure. To the top. Opponent passes. Godless Shrine, untapped. Thought sees you. We will take the... I'll take the bolt. Uro's a little bit away from really being scary. And we do have a path, so we can't answer it. So opponent's hand is just lands in an Uro. The ramping of Uro is okay. We don't especially care about opponent gaining life, though, because when we win, we go all the way. Opponent plays a Scalding, turn passes. All the paths. Well, we will play Safehold Delete. We do need a land, very much. Opponent cracks the Scalding, turn. Gets the Triome. Untaps. Forest. And Uro. Yeah. Sure. Gain some life. Puts the Misty into play. Well, come on, land. Come on, land. Come on, land. Opponent passing. Yeah, land would be spectacular here. We draw Kitchen Figs. All right. Well, get him with Safehold Elite. Hit our opponent. Oh, this feels incredibly bad, but we are going to path our Safehold Elite. We really need lands. We will take a Swamp past the turn. Yeah, that's not how we wanted that to go, but we have a handful of three drops, including a ton of combo pieces, and we need to be able to cast them at some point. Misty Rainforest. So our opponent can get back Uro, but they're going to wait. Looks like perhaps they have a Cryptic Command in hand. And Mystical Sanctuaries? We will play a Kitchen Finks. We got the full combo. Can we actually resolve it, though, is the big question. Well, so we need to resolve Solemnity and Blasting Station. Opponent cracks. Oh, land would be very, very helpful. Boot it. Breeding Pool. Untapped. Fact or Fiction. Oh, God. Yeah, that's a hand. Whew! Okay. Well, we'll give him expensive spells versus cheap spells. Opponent takes the expensive spells. Mystical Sanctuary. Yeah, I think we definitely do want Ley Lines. Yeah, this is not looking great now. Now our opponent has... Ugh, they have everything. Things were looking good for a minute, but we are so far... We're just so pinched on mana. And we've drawn all of our most expensive combo pieces, so it's hard to do multiple things in a turn, which is just giving our opponent tons of time to take the late game advantage, which they definitely have with a handful of Factor Fictions and Cryptics and Snapcasters. Like, we're not going to win the late game. I think we got to jank this deck out early. Like, discard combo pieces, win quick, I think is our path, because once this deck gets going, oh my god. So opponent's going to pass, leave up Cryptic Command and another Factor Fiction. We do draw land. Well, now I guess we get to start running combo pieces into counter spells. Tag our opponent down to 13. We will play a Blasting Station for our opponent to Cryptic Command. Boot it. Oh, they have a Reman too. All right. Well, Godless Shrine tap past the turn. Opponent untaps. Yeah, between Snapcaster and Uro and Mystical Sanctuary, Leyline actually feels very good against our opponent's deck, even though it's not the full-on, like, Dredge-style combo. Opponent tapping and untapping. Here comes the Uro. Yeah. Draws a card, gains some life. Puts the land into play. Opponent passing. Well, we will path the Uro. Opponent gets a land. They also have another... Actually, I guess this can't get Mystic Sanctuary, can it? So they don't have a Mystic Sanctuary here. Get in with the Kitchen Figs. Hit our opponent. Play Blasting Station. Ugh, more remands? Ugh. Ugh. All right. Sure. Stomping Grounds. Untapped. Another remand. Yeah. Well, we will pass. Ugh. Not feeling good. The late game is where our opponent's deck is built to shine. And turn 7 definitely counts. Castle Vantress, even more late game stuff. So our opponent can Snapcaster a remand or a Factor Fiction. Ugh. Well, Inquisition our opponent. Opponent also has to keep the clock in mind. Okay, remand. Wow, they've drawn a lot of remands in a row. Remand number 3. Well, we will Inquisition our opponent. Yeah, they did not have those remands when we last saw their hand. Opponent Cryptics, Bounce, Mystical Sanctuary. Well, Thoughtseize our opponent. Good God. Renin 6, 2 Lightning Bolts, Factor Fiction, Mystical Sanctuary. Well, we'll take the Factor Fiction, although it's a little deceiving because Mystical Sanctuary gets back whatever our opponent wants. Factor Fiction, Remand, Cryptic Command, Opt. Oh, yeah, those three remands in a row were pretty rough. Well, we go to combat. We attack our opponent. Opponent goes to 7. Untaps. Draw. Ooh, all right. Anger the Gods, draw for the turn. That's a good one. Mystical Sanctuary gets back Anger the Gods. Renin 6. How can we get out of this? So in our opponent's hand, it's Bolt Bolt, Field of the Dead, Renin 6. And our opponent's drawing Anger of the Gods next turn. There's a Renin 6. Gets back the Wooded Foothills. Passes. Well, we will play Blasting Station. Pass the turn. We're still doing this in slow mode because we're only able to play one spell a turn. Which is a little clunky. Opponent untaps. So we know they drew the Anger. I mean, maybe we got a shot. Like, Solemnity into Kitchen Fangs. If our opponent does not find another counter spell, that could still steal this win. Field of Ruin, not especially relevant. Opponent's gonna activate, sure. I mean, we have basics left, so this is fine. Grab a Plains. Opponent gets back Field of Ruin. Opponent passes. Well, they get to scry for a counter. Play Windswept Teeth, play Solemnity. Well, this is a big turn. We need our opponent to not draw a way to interact this turn. Pass the turn. They get to scry with Mystical Sanctuary. Cryptics, Snapcasters, any of that kind of stuff would get our opponent out of this. And the scary part is we only really get one shot because of the Anger. Since Anger exiles, it still gets around our Persist. Here's the scry. Come on. Bottom, bottom. Bottom, bottom. Let's see. Bottom, bottom. Bottom, bottom. Bottom, bottom. All right. All right. There's hope. There's hope. Opponent untaps. We could also draw a discard spell, or a silence would be good. Opponent's passing. Oh, boy. Well, this is it. This is the game. All coming down to this one turn. Opponent. We don't know what they... We know they have Bolt Bolt, Anger of the Gods, and a land in hand. They have one card we don't know about. Is it a counter spell? Is it a way to interact with our combo? They did scry 2 to the bottom. We draw. An Offenza. Not especially relevant. Well, I mean, yeah. Here it is. Did you top deck it, opponent? Did you top deck it? Kitchen Finks. Resolves. Well, sack it. Oh, it looks like they did not. It looks like they did not. Untap it. An opponent dead. Oh, taking down the counterspell control deck. Oh, we got there. We got there through the remands and the cryptics. Wow. Okay. We are persisting our way through this league. Not bad. Not bad at all. Sweet, sweet. All right. Much about nothing time. We are playing some Persist Combo, Wombo Combo. I don't know if I really like this hand, honestly. We're up against some sort of Lurus deck, so cheap stuff. We just don't have much. We have, like, a ton of defense, but we're not actually close to comboing. Maybe that's fine? Like, we do get to disrupt our opponent pretty well. Yeah, all right, we'll try it. It is a weird hand, though, without combo pieces. Like, I guess Safeful Delete is technically... It's like half a combo piece. That is, it's our Persist creature, but that's the easiest combo piece to find because we got a ton of them. Bloodstained Mire for our opponent. Cracks it. Oh, it's Burn. Okay, well, this might be fine, then. Concealed Courtyard. Pass the turn. So I think we save the most life by pathing this turn. Plus, we do need to get rid of Soulscar Mage because it puts -1/-1 counters on our Persist creatures, which otherwise are really good blockers. Also, being the deck that has a bunch of main deck Kitchen Finks is Not bad against Burn. Blood Crypt untapped. Bone it. Kiln Fiend. Okay. Goes to combat. Well, we will path... I think we actually path Kiln Fiend. Take one from Soulscar for now. The land does help get our opponent to Lurrus, but they don't have anything to do with it at the moment. So we will Thought Seize our opponent. Take... Take Abbott. Marsh Flats. Pass the turn. I am still a little concerned about this Lurrus. If we spend all of our... If we spend all of our pass on Soul Scars and stuff, this Lurrus does come down. Although I guess all it can get back at the moment is... All it can get back at the moment is an Abbott. Well, we will crack. We will take a Plains. Path the Soulscar Mage. Opponent might have to take Solemnity. Yeah. So opponent's left with just a bunch of stuff until they get the Lurrus. Kitchen Finks would be nice. Kitchen Finks Solemnity probably just beats this deck by itself, honestly. And the lock definitely beats this deck. All right, they take the Solemnity. Manamorphos. And Suspia. And Seal of Fire. All right. Opponent. So their last card is a Lava Dart. Well, play Safehold Elite. Play Godless Shrine. Actually, maybe we Windswept Heath to thin our deck. Windswept Heath, go. So our opponent can Seal of Fire and Lava Dart to get rid of Safehold Elite. We want to try to hold on to this Thought Seize for when our opponent puts Lurrus in their hand. If they do it before they can play it and cast it immediately. They might just wait and try to get to six lands. We kind of help them along that path. All right, this is where we got to start drawing things. Bodet hits us. I'll crack this down to 13. Get a Godless Shrine. Drop to 11. Come on. Come on. Big draw. Big draw. Silent Clearing. I'll play Silent Clearing. Sack Silent Clearing. Inquisition. Not good. Oh boy. Bad timing. Bad timing for the Inquisition. Opponent. Soulscar Mage. Increasing the board presence. Oh, we're running out of time. Oh, I feel like this should be a really good matchup too. We draw. An Offenza. I mean, I guess we play it, but... it doesn't actually do much. So an Offenza go. So far we've been winning our bad matchups, but it looks like we might lose our good matchup. Or at least our game one, Abbott of Carol Keep. Into a land. Yeah, we're going to need two spectacular top decks. I'm surprised our opponent didn't hold on to that land so he could lure us all in one turn. Oh boy. Oh dear. Okay, so we're going to need two, like... miraculously good top decks. Opponent. Attacks. Yeah, they can flashback the Lava Dart. Alright, how can we possibly get out of this? I think it's gotta be like Kitchen Finks into oh boy. Kitchen Finks into Solemnity, maybe? Maybe? And it's a land. Alright. Yeah, so now there's no way out. Interesting. Alright. Well, let's go on to game two. We can bring in Fatal Pushes and Collective Brutalities. We will go down the Carrion Feeders and go down probably a Thought Seize or two. Seems a little sketchy. Maybe we keep a Carrion Feeder and run it back. I mean, this is a matchup we want to be playing. Solemnity Unlife's good. Kitchen Finks is good. We have like, oh, we have so many cards that are good in this matchup. Like, Phyrexian Unlife Solemnity is a free win. Kitchen Finks is very solid. Eh, all right, run it back. I guess our opponent's deck might be better than a typical burn deck because they're Rakdos, and having access to Thought Seize is actually like a pretty big deal for our opponent compared to more typical burn. All right, we are on the play, and yeah, gonna mulligan. One land, no. Oh no. Oh no, Magic Gods, not like this. Oh no. So many cards that we want. So few lands to cast them. Oh, wow, that's awkward. Well, five, I guess. Okay. Well, bottom and bottom. All right, when's some teeth go? Oh, that makes me sad. Now we're super weak to a Thought Seize. Scalding Tarn cracks it. Blood Crypt, untapped. Monastery, Swift Spear. Okay. Opponent hits us for one. Down to 19, we untap. Carrion Feeder. Well, I guess we play it. Not that it does anything, but we will play it. Well, if we draw lands, we have a shot. Solemnity into Kitchen Finks is good, even with a 5-card hand, although we would obviously much rather start with more than 5 cards in hand. If we had a choice, let's say. Pass the turn. Sacred Foundry for our opponent, untapped. Another Swift Spear. Ah, it's a lot of damage. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Alright. Well, this is not good. Well, path the Swift Spear. Lose one of our important cards. Bona gets him out and takes a Kitchen Finks. Well, now we got basically nothing. Well, Windswept Teeth. Crack Windswept Teeth. Get a Plains. Play the Solemnity. Pass the turn. Hit ya, because we can't block anyway. All right, deck. Be good. Abbot of Carol Keep. Hits a land, plays the land, has the lava dart to kill the carrion feeder. Ugh. So now we definitely need multiple draws to do anything. Nile Spellbomb, ouch. That makes things even less possible. Hits us down to 12. Thoughtseize. Ugh. Wow. Magic is a very funny game. It is one of the strangest games. So far, we're 2-0 beating decks that I would consider to be much more difficult matchups than this one, but we were just getting absolutely spanked by what should be, like, one of our best matchups. Yeah, here they come. Yeah, we're actually just straight up dead. Thoughtseize. Yeah, there's, well, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so we stay. No, we're dead to Lava Dart. We're just dead right now. The only reason we'd stay in is because Phyrexian Unlife would win us the game, but... Yeah, alright. Wow. Okay. Well, I wouldn't mind playing Burn again this league if we get a shot, just because I really think that is truly one of our best matchups in the format. Yeah, alright, on to the next. Alright, we are on to round... Ugh. One lander again. Alright, we'll mulligan this. Okay, well, this will keep. This hand's interesting. We have the most painful lands in history. But in theory, we have Solemnity Unlife and an Offenza and a Sack Outlet. So we actually have most of our combo if we can actually resolve it and draw lands. So all things considered, this isn't the worst. Although we would prefer different lands at the moment. Well, Silent Clearing and Carrion Feeder. Go. See what our opponent's up to. We definitely need at least one more land. Inspiring Vantage. Gob. Oh, come on, lands. Come on, land. Come on, land. Come on, land. Opponent gets in, hits us. All right, that's a land. That is good. That is very good. And a Kitchen Finks. Well, go to combat. Hit our opponent with Carrion Feeder. Godless Shride. Untapped. We do get a rematch against Burn. Oh, this is risky. And Offenza. Pass the turn. This should be fine, because we just get to Unlife into Solemnity. And that just essentially guarantees the win. All right, Searing Blaze, sure. Down to 11, down to 9. Bad news for our opponent is we have a Swamp, and we get to play Phyrexian Unlife and hit our opponent. Eidolon of the Great Revel hits us. Altar of Dementia on top. Well, we will play a Solemnity. Drop to 3, but that should just be game. I don't even think we got to do anything the rest of the game. Pass the turn. Like, I think our opponent's just drawing dead to this, right? I mean, this is what's supposed to happen against Burn. This is why, and we have 2 Kitchen Finks in hand and an infinite combo. Like, this is how it's supposed to go. Almost exactly like this. This is why Burn should just be, like, a spectacular matchup for our deck. And opponent scoops it up. Yeah, that is more like it. Oh, sorry, Burn. Sorry. All right, so against Burn, I think we go Brutalities, Fatal Pushes, Greater Oromancies. We go down Carrion Feeders and Thought Seizes. So idea is, against Burn, the easiest way to win the game is just lock them with Solemnity and Unlife. That is really, really strong. Greater Oromancy makes it so our opponent can't just, like, Destructive Revelry or whatever, away our main lock pieces. And then Brutality, Life Gain Removal, Fatal Push, more removal for the creatures. Carrion Feeder's kind of min this deck. I almost wonder if it'd be better as Viserys here, honestly. So, on one hand, if you combo off, you can make an infinitely big Carrion Feeder, because it gets a counter when you sack something. So, like, Carrion Feeder and Offensive Kinchin Fangs, infinitely big Carrion Feeder. That's pretty sweet. On the other end, it's just a direct non-bow with Solemnity, since it can't get counters. So, unless you're comboing with that Offensive, it actually just doesn't do much of anything. So, eh. Viscera Seer Scrying seems, like, somewhat relevant, at least. Sounds kind of meh. I think we're going to mulligan it. We don't have any of our stuff that's actually, like, good in this matchup. Ouch. This might be worse. The only redeeming quality of this hand is we do have the combo. The problem is we only have one land. And it's the fragile combo. Five it is. All right. We will keep. We will put Putrid Goblin and Safehold Elite to the bottom, I guess. We'll draw more Persist creatures eventually. Sacred Foundry for our opponent tapped. And passes. Well, Conceal Courtyard, you. Scalding Tarn for our opponent, cracks it, grabs a mountain, and Eidolon. Yeah, let's just Fatal Push it, I think. Actually, you know what? Let's not. Let's wait. Collector Brutality is probably better. Save this for, like, a hasty threat. Play a Plains. I think we 2-mode? Duress and Kill. Discard a Silent Clearing. And this lets us get rid of something that can blow up Solemnity, potentially. Or just a burn spell. Oh, opponent just has a bunch of burn. We'll take Boros Charm. Well, this gives us a lot of time to find something. Opponent's just got two bolts and a redraw in hand. And we're at 18. There's a Rift Bolt. And the Sunbait Canyon. Opponent passes. Well, play the land. Play Solemnity. Pass the turn. We don't have the Unlife, though. Or any Persist creatures. Finding, like, a Kitchen Finks would be good. If we don't draw anything good, we'll definitely sack the Silent Clearing. Next turn, down to 15. Rift Bolt again. And Skewer, all right, down to 12. Virtual 9. Well, play an Offensive. And Silent Clearing. Pass the turn. Ooh, we'll see. We'll see, we'll see. Show us an Unlife or a Kitchen Finks. Those are our best hits here. Rift Bolt. Going face. Down to 9. Scalding Tarn, two cards in hand. Opponent, passing. Well, sag the land draw card. More removal. And more lands. Well, go to combat, hit you with an Offensive. Oh, we're giving our opponent a ton of time to draw bird spells. Hit ya. Down to 17 past the turn. Opponent does not crack the Scalding Tarn, plays a land. Well, if they're going to draw lands, that's the one they want, because they can turn it into a burn spell, hopefully, or a new card. Opponent, passing. I don't think we crack our land. Do we crack it? No, we don't. Ugh, second hand Offensive. I wish we had cracked it. Get it with that Offensive. Hit you down to 15. Opponent cracks. Uh-oh. They got a Searing Blaze? Ugh. Searing Blaze down to 6. That is 2 burn spell rage. Pass the turn. Another, oh boy, opponent's hitting all the redraw lads. Sacks it. Passes. Unlife. Unlife. Well, Kitchen Finks is decent. Kitchen Finks. Unless our opponent has Skullcrack, then it's not. Opponent does have Skullcrack, so we go to 3. Kitchen Finks. Bolster and Offensive. Go to combat. Hit ya. Oh, but we're in 1 burn spell range. Down to 14. Opponent untaps. Well, all right. Crack this. Down to 2. This probably still isn't going to work, but it's our 1 pseudo shot. Swamp. Fatal Push Kitchen Finks. And more burn. Okay, they kill the Solemnity. Okay. Well, we get back Kitchen Finks. And Offensive persists. We go up to 4. We go down to 1. Unlife. Unlife. Sack out. Oh! That is an unlife. Oh my god. Unlife. Oh, that buys us time. That buys us a ton of time. Hit ya. Oh, the magic gods coming through in the clutch on the ball to 5. And they spent their wear tear on the Solemnity for not much value. Sack outlet? Silent clearing. Well, play silent clearing. Sack it to draw a card. Our turn for the redraw. Sack outlet. Godless Shrine. All right. Well, go to combat. Attack ya. Hit ya. An opponent's on a fast clock, down to 4. That's technically lethal next turn. Oh! Oh, what a game! They draw another wear tear, and then a bird spell. Oh! Wow! Wow! All right. Well, that was, whew! That was ridiculously close. All right. Well, we will run it back. Wow. On a multi-5, and we were still super close. Oh, opponent drew all the wear tears. You can see why Greater Oromancy has value. Like, if we had Greater Oromancy, our opponent would have to start targeting the Greater Oromancies first, and they just don't have enough enchantment removal. Let's get a good hand. This is an okay hand. We do have the Unlife, and we have Brutality to protect it. Little disappointed they drew 2 wear tears after we did manage to Thought Seize them, but we're not especially close to comboing, though. Windswept Teeth. Yeah. And we have a semi-painful mana base at the moment. About it. Inspiring Vantage. Goblin Guide. Let's see what it reveals. Top card is Greater Oromancy. Do we want that? Yeah, we probably do. So, untap, draw Greater Oromancy. Windswept Teeth, crack it. Grab 8 Plains. Concealed Courtyard. Collective Brutality, 2 modes. Kill Goblin Guide, duress you. Discarding. I think we just go Blasting Station for now. Well, take the wear tear. Pass the turn. Gonna need to find Solemnity. Opponent. Sunbaked Canyon. Runs out the Eidolon. Windswept Teeth. Crack Windswept Teeth. Grab a Plains. Phyrexian Unlife. Down to 14. Without Solemnity, though, we can still just die to... even with the Unlife on the battlefield. Oh, all right. Well, play Greater Oromancy. Down to 10. Silent Clearing. Well, this should buy us some time. Opponent passes. Opponent's going to need... We took a Wear Tear. They're going to need 2 more Wear Tears. Helixes us. Down to 7. Untaps. And if we ever draw the other Greater Oromancy, then we have just the Hard Lock. Swift Spear. Yeah. And Lightning Bolt. Down to 4. Down to 0. Well, Sack Silent Clearing. Untap. Solemnity. Silent Clearing. Go. All right. Well, opponent can't do anything until they start wear tearing us. They need multiple wear tears or other ways to deal with our enchantments. Opponent hits us 4-0 and scoops it up. Whoo! That's how it's supposed to go against Bird. Wow. Well, you can see how good Thoughtseize can be. We lost to the Rakdos Bird deck. In large part because of Thoughtseize. Also some mulliganing issues. But that's basically why Burn is supposed to be a really good matchup for this deck. And that doesn't even include the potential of Infinite Kitchen Fix life. All right, sweet, sweet. All right, much Brew About Nothing time. We are going for the 4-1 with the new and improved, updated, formerly Budget Magic deck, Persist Combo, in Modern. And, see how it goes. See how it goes. I think we actually keep this. We have Solemnity and Carrion Feeder. What is our opponent playing? Boggles? Okay. Definitely Boggles. This will be interesting. Well, Conceal Courtyard and Thought Sees You. Spider Umbra Ranker. Daybreak Coronet. I'll take Daybreak Coronet. So I think we just got a combo before we die. Unlife Solemnity should be very strong if we can get it down. We still need the Unlife. We do have the Solemnity. We could also find a Persist creature and go infinite before we die. That's the other hope. Spider Umbra and Ranker. So we're taking 4 a turn at the moment. Opponent hits us. We draw Path. That's not great. Well, play the land. Play Carrion Feeder. Ooh, I don't know if we're going to be fast enough. We'll see what our opponent draws. Hopefully they can't further grow this Glade Cover Scout, or we're really going to be in trouble. Horizon Canopy. All that glitters. Oh, God. Okay, yeah, that's not what we wanted to see. Opponent gets in, hits us. Yeah. Unlife, please? Right now? Altar of Dementia. Yeah, okay. Well, that's Boggles for you. Yeah, this is mostly a race. We don't want to show our opponent any more of our deck, because that could help them find our answers. So we're going to bring in 4 disenchants. We're going to go down Path to Exile. I mean, this is just straight up race mode. Little risky to down Path, because we could get Core Spirit answered, but, go down Carrion Feeder. Do we want greater Oromancies? Carrion Feeder doesn't do anything, right? Yeah, let's go down. Let's go up the greater Oromancies, too. Yeah, more like that. Well, we are on the play, which is good. Being on the play is super helpful because it means our Thought Seizes can be live to take our opponent's Hexproof creature. Okay. Well, this is another pathway to victory. So we can't disrupt our opponent, but we do have Solemnity Unlife. And we'll see if our opponent has an answer. And the disenchant's good, although unfortunately mismatched. I updated the main deck to make sure all the cards look pretty, but I forgot about the sideboard. Opponent, Wood Foothills, cracks it. Temple Garden and Glade Cover Scout. Well, play Silent Clearing, play an Offensa. The question's going to be, does our opponent know the matchup? Did they bring an enchantment hate? That is maybe the biggest question we have at the moment. Horizon Canopy. Ranker. And Ethereal Arbor. Sure. No, no blocks. There is risk here. We're down to 19. Down to 14. Now, Silent Clearing. Oh. Down to 12 for Unlife. So the problem... Oh, we could have a... Yeah, Unlife. There is an issue here. The issue is, if our opponent can hit us low enough, we won't be able to tap our Silent Clearings for mana to cast the Solemnity. So we need to not get hit so low that we can't play Solemnity. And there is a risk. If our opponent can play another, like, big Aura Ranker, 8 power, rest in peace. Okay. Okay. This does mean we get to get down Solemnity, and then we just go from there. Opponent gets in, hits us. So we will... Do we just block? We're not going to have much mana. I guess we're going to lose all of our mana anyway. We go to 3. Graveyard Hate shuts down our main combo for now. Yeah, let's block. This means we can crack a fetch if we happen to draw it to get another real mana. Down to 5. Untap. Well, real mana is not bad. 1, 2, 3. Ooh, Solemnity. Concealed Courtyard, go. Okay. We're alive, unless our opponent has enchantment removal. Then we're very much not alive. Did our opponent bring in enchantment removal? Opponent's thinking. Jank him out. It's funny how effective this lock is against some decks. It's actually, like, way more effective. Oh! No answers! No answers! And I think we would have... Nothing forever. Well, I was going to say I think we would win eventually, but we were going to draw nothing for a while. Because we have... A persist creature. All we really need is a sack outlet, but we're gonna draw a lot of nothing. Well, the lock held. That's the most important thing. Yeah. I mean, this is what we got. Run it back. Pray to the magic gods for some good luck. All right, opponent's on the play. That does make our Thought Seizes less effective. Wouldn't mind a traditional moldify boggle sand where you gotta dig desperately to find your payoff. Opponent's keeping. What does this hand do? It doesn't lock our opponent out of the game. Oromancy's pretty dead. The only argument for keeping it is we do have Altar of Dimension to Kitchen Finks, which gives us a potential, like, turn 4 win, but is that even fast enough? Wow, this is really close. I think we mulligan. Oh, it's so risky. Yeah, we mulligan. Okay, that's... worse. We need to draw multiple lands. All right, 5 it is. We will put a safe hold elite and a marsh flats to the bottom. Yeah, okay. Well, show us a unlife. Razor Verge Thicket and Boggle. Yeah, Mishore Slips. Well, the disenchants are not bad. Thossy's our opponent. Wow. Wow, 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 wow. Okay. I think we have to take Spirit Dancer. This does mean there's a Seal of Primordium to deal with our first enchantment. But if Spirit Dancer comes down, our opponent just gets to go off. I mean, I guess we can disenchant the seal if our opponent plays it early. Spider Umbra, opponent hits us for 2. We draw creature? Land? Alright, Windswept Teeth, go. Boot it. There's a land. Griff's Boon. Yep. clock increasing. We can, like, blow up an enchantment, but it just doesn't do a ton. It's, like, saving a single damage right now. I think we gotta get something more impactful than a Spider Umbra. All right. Kitchen Finks would actually be a reasonably good draw. Crack this. Godless Shrine tapped. Take our beads. Down to 13. Draw. Well, okay. Inquisition you. Take Seal of Primordium. Play the land. Well, this does kind of leave us live to draw Spirit Mantle. 4, 5. Ugh. So we 3, 4. 4, 8, 12. So the clock is... Well, Is it even worth killing something? Yeah. Ugh. This isn't good, but we're getting so close to death. Let's kill the Spirit Mantle. Oh, we really need to draw Unlife? Kitchen Finks would also be acceptable. Well, okay. Solemnity. There's a chance we're dead this turn. Opponent untaps. No, not all the glitters. Daybreak Coronet. So we're going to one? Okay, so we have to top deck Unlife this turn. That's it. 4 out of 50. Magic gods, how much do you love us? How much do you love Persist Combo? This is your chance to show us. Ooh, I don't want to look. I don't want to look. Unlife. Unlife. Oh my god, it is Unlife. Oh, okay, the 4 out of 50 hits. We do know our opponent has answers, so they will get out of this eventually. So we still do need to keep hitting good things. Ethereal Armor. Hits us for a bunch that isn't really much of anything. Okay, now we need to win before our opponent draws a way to answer this. And Offenza, well, okay, that's a step in the right direction. Might as well Inquisition, not gonna get better. Leyline of Sanctity. Ooh, okay. Opponent untaps. Well, can we find the win before our opponent finds a way to blow up an enchantment? Rancor, doesn't do anything. Opponent, wow, that was the best top deck. Sure, hit us, that's fine. For a million. Now, play Silent Clearing. Sack it. Another Anafenza. Not especially helpful. Pass the turn. Every draw step is scary, because we know our opponent has cards in their deck that just win the game, that we can't stop. More Anchors. We could also draw a way to protect our enchantments, would be good. Opponent gets in. Sure. We draw. Godless Shrine. Tapped. Pass the turn. Oh, the most awkward race. Opponent untaps. Draws. What is it? Eventually, they're going to draw lands. 2 mana. Another Daybreak Coronet. So, opponent's gaining ridiculous amounts of life. Hits us. Sure. We draw. Silent Clearing. We'll play it. Sack it. A better looking disenchant. Disenchants aren't doing a whole lot at the moment, though. We do need one for the Leyline of Sanctity, but... Opponent. Combat. Hits us. Gains a ridiculous amount of life. Sure. We draw. Okay. Altar of Dementia. That's good. That puts us one draw away. One draw away from the win. We just need the Persist creature. Opponent. Can we draw a Persist creature before our opponent draws an answer? Core Spirit answer. Okay, that's not good. That's going to draw our opponent cards. Oh, come on, Magic Gods. Come on, Magic Gods. That's going to help our opponent find the answer. Come on, Persist creature. Show us the figs. Show us the figs. Oh my goodness, that's the figs. And unless our opponent has a surgical extraction, that's game. That's game. Yeah. Comes into play, bolster, whatever, Kate's life, and let the milling begin. Sack it, mill you. Do you have an answer? It looks like no. All right, mill them out, mill them out. Sack it, mill you. Down to 40. 37. Scoops it up. Wow. Well, we cannot complain about getting unlucky for the next few months. Because that top deck was insane. We were dead. We had 4 out of 50 to hit the unlife, and we hit it. That was a life-saving draw. This deck is sweet, though. This deck is super sweet. Persist Combo. I mean, it was sweet when we played it for Budget Magic, but now I think it's becoming, like, an actual competitive deck. Like, yeah, there's some upgrades. You get the Thought Seizes, adding a color. It does increase the price, but if you have the budget build, it shouldn't be too hard to upgrade, depending on your collection, into the fully power build. And then you have a deck that You could win an FNM with this. You could 5-0 a league. We just went 4-1, which is really close. And our match that we lost was against Burn, which is normally a really good matchup. So the deck definitely proved its power, especially if you get lucky. Like, the luck is definitely part of it. Well, anyway, Craig opened the chest. 5 chests for the 4-1. First off, we get... could use a Muxus. Some of the commander cards, well, not Lightning Visionary. Some of the jumpstart cards, rather, are super expensive. Allosaurus Rider Muxus, in specific, are ridiculously expensive. Force of Nature. That's more expensive than it looks. You see a 6-mana 8-8 with Trample, but on your upkeep, you either take 8 or you pay 4. That is a lot. Some of these lands are pretty sweet. All right, 3 to go. Come on. Something better than Force of Nature. Something fitting of our 4-1. Well, Ren and Siri is a sweet card. I don't think it has much value, though, because of how Modo works. Maybe because Redemption's still a thing. 94 cents. What about a Shiny Impetus? Shiny, so the Impetuses, I think, are just pretty bad, but 34 cents. 2 to go. 2 more shots for a complete set for a Muxus. Grind Clock and Royal Elemental. Pretty sweet commander card. But, all right. Last one. One more shot for goodies. It is Thriving Isle. I know this was expensive, but because it sees a lot of play in Pauper. However, they increased the supply a lot. Yeah, it was. So this was not that long ago, like a month ago, almost 10 tickets. And then even more recently was like 3 or 4 tickets, but it's down to 129. So it still has a bit of value. But, all right. Well, that is the beauty of Persist Combo. The deck actually felt really good. Kind of crushed it. Oh, so close to the 5-0. We've been in a lot of 4-1s lately with a relatively janky deck. So, not bad. All right. I'll be back with a wrap-up. So, what did we learn this week about Persist Combo in Modern? And the deck felt really solid. We played a league. We went 4-1 with our one loss coming to, like, a Rakdos Prowess deck, a Rakdos Bird-style deck, which actually seems like it should be a really good matchup. I mean, we played straight-up Boros Bird, and we just absolutely crushed that, because what do I do about Phyrexian Unlife's Limnity? Not a whole lot. So, regardless, we were really close to a 5-0. The deck feels really good. It's very powerful. The thing that makes this deck sweet is it's just got so much redundancy. It looks janky on paper, and it has a lot of janky cards, but because we have Solemnity and Anafenza, because we have 10 Persist creatures, because we have Altar of Dementia, Blasting Station, and Carrion Feeder, we just have a ridiculous amount of redundant combo pieces. So even though we need 3 different pieces to go infinite, the odds of us finding it are actually not that bad, because we just have so many versions and different versions of each effect in each combo piece. So I think the deck is actually pretty competitive. We did get some Jacob out with Unlife's Limited wins, which that lock is so good. I don't know why that doesn't see more play in Modern, because every time we play it, we just crush people. We got a lot of infinite combo wins, so I definitely think if you built the original mono white Persist combo deck like a year ago for Budget Magic, I think this is a very solid upgrade path. You already have the core of the deck. You go into black to get some sideboard cards and discard. The discard is very good in the deck. The discard gives us protection, essentially. That's the biggest upside, is we're able to turn one Thoughtseize to get rid of something that would, I don't know, Path to Exile our Kitchen Sphinx, or an Abrupt Decay that would hit our Solemnity, a counterspell that would stop any of our stuff. So being able to Thoughtseize Inquisition on turn one does greatly strengthen the combo, and it is a big upgrade. So yeah, I think this is a great upgrade path from the budget deck, and it's really sweet to see this Budget Magic deck essentially becoming at least a semi-real deck in the format. And more importantly, if you are upgrading the budget deck, it's still only $500. I know, only $500. Not trying to minimize how much $500 is, but compared to a lot of Modern decks, $488 isn't that bad. You already probably have most of the deck thanks to the budget deck if you built that deck. So you're really paying for like Thoughtseize, which was just reprinted and dropped a lot. The fetch lands, I guess, is a big one in Silent Clearing, although I think you can get by without them if you wanted to, and the deck would still be pretty functional. If you dropped, especially the Marsh Flats, you can at least play all the Windswept Tees to minimize the Zendikar fetch lands in the deck. So it shouldn't be that costly of an upgrade. The deck is good. The deck is fun. It combos off. It locks people out. It's just a really sweet deck all around. So that's Persist Combo. New, improved, upgraded. That's our budget brew for this week. Thanks for watching. I hope you all enjoyed it, and I will talk to you soon.
Thanks for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, help us out by clicking that like button down below. And to keep up on all the latest and greatest, click that subscribe button. And don't forget to hit that bell icon to get alerts whenever we have new videos. And if you want to, check out some of our other sweet videos here and here.